Hello children, it is me, your robotic Sonic the Hedgehog father. How are you enjoying your Mega MIDI? Is it everything you always hoped for and more? No? You desire software control? You'd like to control the registers of the YM2612 through a DAW-compatible plugin? I see. Well, I'll just assign my code slave to that. It shouldn't take him more than a few moments. Hehehe. He wouldn't want to disappoint me. Not again, anyways. After. Last time.
5 months later.
Oh my god, it's finally done.
Hey everybody, I have something new for you. This is Mega MIDI Control, my VST that is cross-platform and can be installed into DAWs. So this can actually directly control your Mega MIDI's YM2612, and you have access to all the different parameters on the chip. So I have my Mega MIDI connected to my computer with a little keyboard, and if I start playing, I just have this little organ voice that's loaded up, but I can actually change any of the parameters and modify the patch in real time. So if I change the algorithm, you can hear the voice change in real time. I can also modify a lot of these different parameters. So now you get the idea. I'm not really doing anything specific, but it proves the point. You can modify your patches in real time and listen to them as you play. Now, every single one of these modulators is actually accessible within your DAW. So if you want the DAW to control these attributes, you can do it. Another thing that you can do is, if you remember, the Mega MIDI used to only load pre-made patch files from its SD card, but you can also load those same OPM patch files directly from the software. And if I open this, it automatically sends the patch over. Now that one's a little bit loud. Let's pick another one. You can pick all the individual patches inside of the OPM file, and they're instantly sent to the Mega MIDI. Not only that, but once you load that patch, you can modify all the attributes of it. Now let's say that you've come up with a patch that you really want to save, and if you remember, on the face of the Mega MIDI, there are 7 favorite buttons. You can click any one of these favorite buttons right here, and now the patch is saved to favorite button 2. So all you have to do is press the 2 button, and you'll go right back to it. This VST is based on a heavily modified version of the CTRLR panel that Thea Flowers made, and she actually just recently did a really cool talk with Hackaday, so I definitely recommend go checking her out. She makes a lot of cool electronic stuff, and she actually made her own Sega Genesis synthesizer as well, so I'll link that in the description too.
Wow, that sounds great. How do I use Mega MIDI Control?
So to use Mega MIDI Control, there are a couple things you need to do first. One, you need to make sure that your Mega MIDI is on version 1.3 or higher. If it's not on version 1.3, I've actually created a brand new flashing script written in Python, along with another video to show you how to use it. All you're going to need is an Arduino Uno. Once you're on firmware version 1.3, you're ready to use Mega MIDI Control. Now, depending on your operating system, there are a few versions of the panel. If you're on Windows, there's a standalone executable as well as 2 DLL VSTs that you can plug directly into your DAW. If you're on macOS or Linux, you're going to need to install the controller program, or CTRLR. CTRLR exists as a standalone, but it also exists as a VST file and an audio unit that you can plug into DAWs. Once you have either controller standalone or the controller audio unit or VST, you can open the panel for Mega MIDI Control and run it just like any other VST. Finally, before you use Mega MIDI Control, make sure your Mega MIDI is connected to your computer as well as any accessories you plan to use, like MIDI controllers or keyboards. If you plan to use it in a DAW, make sure you go to your MIDI settings and ensure that the Mega MIDI is not synchronized to the DAW itself. Then, after you open Mega MIDI Control, you're going to need to go to MIDI, Input, if you have a MIDI keyboard that you'd like to control the Mega MIDI with, and Output, and make sure you click Mega MIDI. You're now ready to go.
Well done, my son.